Anansi the Spider. A long time ago in Ghana, there was a spider by the name of Anansi. Now some call him Anansi the Spider Man. Sometimes he appears as an insect. Sometimes he appears as a man. Sometimes they see him up on the ceilings, and the children even call him Ceiling Thomas. Well, one day, Anansi's family told him, "We want some food." So off Anansi went, walking through the woods as fast as he could go. He was walking down towards the river when what he heard way in the distance was something that sounded like this. Anansi wanted to know what he heard, but he was too far away, so he couldn't tell. So he came closer and closer to the river, and again he heard the sound, and it sounded something like this. Now Anansi thought he knew what they were saying, but he still wasn't sure. So he still came closer until he's out behind the baobab tree down by the river. And there he looked around the tree, and he saw the river spirits, and they were singing this song.
Oh, we splash the river to catch the fishes. Oh, we splash our heads upon the water. Oh, we splash the river.
And the river spirits kept singing the song over and over. Now meanwhile, they had their heads off and in their hands. They were splashing their heads upon the water. And as their heads hit the water and they sang the song, the fish would jump out of the water. They would catch them and throw them on the shore to eat later. And time after time, they kept singing the song.
Oh, we splashed the river to catch the fishes. Oh, we splash our heads upon the water. Oh, we splash the river.
And Anansi watched. And Anansi says, "Oh, I like that song." The river spirits saw him. And they said, "Anansi, brother Anansi." For all of the spirits knew Anansi, as did all of the animals in the kingdom and all of the people. "Anansi, come and join us."
"Boy, I would like to," said Anansi, "but there is a problem."
"Well, what is that?" said the river spirit. "You tell it and we will fix it." "I don't know how to take my head off," said Anansi. "Oh, that's easy," said the river spirits. They helped him take his head off and they put his head in his hands. And then Anansi joined the river spirits floating above the river, pressing his head up and down upon the water, singing the song.
"Oh, we splash the river to catch the fishes. Oh, we splash our heads upon the water. Oh, we splash the river."
"Oh, this is fun," said Anansi. And Anansi splashed his head upon the water, and the fish would jump out, and Anansi could catch them and throw them on the shore. Now, because Anansi was a spider with 8 legs, instead of only 2, he caught more fish than the river spirits. He was greedy and wanted fish, but he was also lazy and did not want to carry too many home. So finally Anansi said, "I think I'm going to go now." And they said, "Okay, Anansi, come again and join us sometime." "Oh, I'd like to," said Anansi, but before I go, there is a problem."
"What's that?" said the river spirit. "You tell us, man, and we will fix it."
I don't know how to put my head back on," said Anansi. "Oh, that's easy," said the river spirits. They helped him put his head back upon his shoulders where it belonged. Now Anansi spun a giant web sack and filled it full of fish and was ready to go home. "Ah," the river spirit said, "brother Anansi, we need to tell you something before you go."
"Well, what's that?" said Anansi. "You tell me anything, I will listen."
"You never sing our song again. If you sing the song, your head will fall right off."
Ooh, boy. Well, Anansi said, then I won't be singing the song. He took the web sack and he put it on his back and started going to home where his family lived. But as he went home, he heard way in the distance the song again. The river spirits were still singing, and the sound sounded like this. And Anansi could not help himself. He reared back his head and he went, oh, splash the river. Poor. His head fell right off. Now, try as he might, Anansi could not get his head back up on his shoulders where it was supposed to be. He went for the river spirits to help, but they were gone. The best he could do was to put his head onto his rear end. He took his web sack and went home as fast as he could, with the web sack full of fish and his head balanced on his tail. His children, they came to the door when they saw him coming. Oh, look at Father, they said. His head's on his rear end. He says, be quiet and help me get my head on straight. Children, do not laugh at your father. They tried and they tried, but they could not get the head off of the back to put it on the front. The best they could do is to pull out the two eyeballs. And they put the eyeballs on the little stump in the front. They undid the nose. And they put the nose on the little stump in front. They pulled the mouth off. Oh, that hurt. And they put the mouth on the front. They tried to pull out the ears, but the ears would not come. So they went pook, pook, and they poked in the ears. Did you ever notice that spiders do not have ears? And when they were done, Anansi looked different. What he had was a little teeny head and a great big behind. Now, every spider you see today, no matter how big, no matter how small, they always have a little head and a great big behind. And that's the tale of Anansi the Spider and why spiders have big rear ends. Ha 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 ha!